everyone, welcome back to Sugar Mama TV. I am financial planner Kanna Campbell. Today's video is a decluttering minimalism video. I know it's been a while since I've made a video for you on this subject matter, and I apologize for that. I promise you I'll be making more of this type of content for you on a regular basis, and I'm already starting to stockpile my library. The truth is, we've moved house, and I've had a lot of like confronting, challenging moments with my love of minimalism because we've moved into a slightly bigger home, and there have been times where I've had to compromise, adapt, be very mindful and aware of, you know, entering a new space and the dangers of new things coming in. So that is the reason why I've kind of avoided this subject matter until now. Now, today's video is a short but sweet one. I want to talk you through things that I'm decluttering right now. Now, these are things that I've been sitting on for a really long time. It's a pile of stuff that I've been umming and ahhing and thinking, no, hold on to it. It might be, you know, you might not want to let go of it. You might regret it. And talk you through how I've come to this decision. But also I want to share with you the lesson that I've learned in letting it go. Everything you see in this video will actually be available to buy if you want. Obviously only for people who are interested, because you might be able to grab a bargain. But I really want to talk to you about in this video is how I've come to the decision of letting it go. Why? And this might help you in your own minimalism journey as you learn to let go of things and declutter and create more space and more lightness, more clarity, more efficiency and purpose in your own life as you embrace more minimalism. First up is this Dion Lee dress. This dress is a beautiful dress. I do love it. However, let me talk you through the story, and this is a big lesson for me to learn. Dion Lee is an Australian designer. They're not exactly cheap dresses, you could say. I was saving up for ages for this dress, not this one. Anyway, saving up for ages, finally went to the store to buy the dress and was disappointed to discover that dress had actually sold out. So instead of just saying, all right, bad luck, it was not meant to be, and walk out of the store not buy anything and save my money, I decided to buy the next best thing. Now, I now regret this because it is a beautiful dress, but it wasn't really what I was looking for. It's beautiful, it's stunning, however, it's not quite right for me. It's a little bit too short for me. Where it cuts me off on my knees isn't particularly flattering to my legs. And I have to let it go. I don't enjoy reaching for it and putting it on, which is another big lesson to learn. But for me, if I'm saving up for something and it's gone, I need to just make peace with that, accept what it is, and not try and replicate that feeling of buying the next second best thing, but just move on and wait until you find something that you absolutely love, value, use, and appreciate. So the rule is, don't ever settle or compromise when it comes to spending your hard-earned money. Lesson number two, the dangers of buying a brand that you're not familiar with online. This dress here, now this was I bought it from the Iconic. It was supposed to be just a fun, very pretty summer dress. And it was absolutely fine. It's done well. But again, one of my rules is if I'm going to buy something online, I need to make sure I'm very familiar with that brand. So I know the quality, I know the cuts, I know the fabrics, I know like how durable the material is. And I broke my own rules and I got it wrong. And it doesn't fit properly. It's too big in some areas and too tight in other areas. And I just realized, you know what, just because it was cheap, and that was probably the key decision, reason why I bought it, and the biggest lesson here for me is, don't necessarily buy something because it's cheap or on sale. Make sure you're really familiar with the brand if you're going to be shopping online. So this is going to be up for grabs on my Instagram account at Kanna Campbell Official. A Cecile Copenhagen top. Really classic, really pretty. I actually love this top. However, it started to fade, and again, the fabric is not great for my skin. Their dresses and tops are absolutely beautiful. However, I tend to really sweat in them. I don't know why, but it just doesn't breathe on my skin. I've got a couple of their tops and I've had their outfits before, and I've always had to let them go. I don't know why when I knew this, I still went and bought this top, knowing that I'd probably have the same thing. I guess the reason why I justified this particular purchase for myself is because I saw it on one of my girlfriends and it looked amazing. But again, another lesson, the fabric. Can you breathe in it? Does it feel comfortable? Is it going to wash well? Is it soft? And the moment you realize there's a brand that doesn't make that type of fabric or that type of cut or style, don't get tempted to go there again. You don't need to learn your mistake 3 or 4 times in a row. Learn quickly, learn fast. Next item where I stuffed up, and this one I can be a little bit more gentle on myself. Now, this is a rag and bone denim skirt. I bought this in London with Tom. And I tried it on in the store and it fitted like a glove. It was perfect. I absolutely loved it. It was sexy, it was slimming, it fit, grabbed me in all the right places. And I still do absolutely love, love, love this skirt. However, I put a little bit of weight on. And I'm gonna say, I think I might be fooling myself, but in fact, the skirt, I think, has shrunk a little bit in the wash. And so what happens is the skirt rides up on my hips a little bit too much, and the slit got for my thighs goes up a little bit too high. And I'm starting to feel uncomfortable in this. So this is actually a skirt that I intend in replacing, and I'll make sure that the size does fit me, and I'll check when I go to pay for that item with the sales consultant whether their skirts do shrink at all in the wash. But again, I love this. This is just what happens in life. You can't always get every single purchase perfectly, but I need to let this go because again, I feel uncomfortable when I wear this. I feel nervous and a bit embarrassed about how much the slit comes up my leg now that it's shrunk a little bit, or I most likely have probably put on a little bit too much weight. Lesson next is, this is a Victoria and Woods dress. All right, this was actually, I never bought from this shop before, and they do make absolutely beautiful pieces. They're an Australian designer, really well made, and I think ethically sourced as well. All right, what went wrong with this? It faded in the wash. I was really disappointed by this. And again, this is one of the dangers of experimenting with different brands that you haven't shopped with before. And I have to say, since having this experience, I haven't really returned to the store since. It wasn't a cheap dress. I think it was about $300. It's a super comfortable dress, so I am disappointed to see it go. However, one of my best friends bought the same dress as I bought, and they had the exact same problem where the fabric faded in the wash. And I didn't throw it in a hot wash. I threw it in a cold wash. I followed the instructions again. Disappointing. So, and I think the thing is, sometimes when fabrics fade so much, you don't feel good about yourself because it looks tired, it looks tacky, it looks tatty, and that can just reflect back on you. So it's been a hard one to let this go because it is so comfortable. And look, I could say, well, I'll just wear it around the house or whatever. But the reality is, I want to make sure that even if I am floating around the house when no one can see me, that I feel good about myself. The last item coming up for grabs, and the last lesson for me to deal with as I let go of stuff in my home, and that is these beautiful shoes. I say beautiful because they look beautiful. Again, a lesson on buying something because it's cheap and because it's online. These were uncomfortable. They're not a particularly high shoe, which is a good thing, but they're uncomfortable. This part on my, and I have dumpling feet, they're quite podgy and fat, but this part is just a little bit too tight for my foot. So I wear these and about an hour later, my foot inflates like a pink marshmallow and is cut off with this strap. So it's incredibly uncomfortable. The truth is, as pretty as they look sitting in my wardrobe, every time I go to grab them, I'm reminded of the pain of wearing them about an hour later, and it's simply not worth it. Again, being really careful of buying things online, knowing your size, knowing the quality, knowing the fit, and making sure that you don't do the same thing again. So I will be letting these beautiful shoes, and a fantastic color might I add, go on my Instagram account. When you're going through your own wardrobe trying to declutter things, ask yourself these key questions. Number one, how does it feel on me? Does it feel soft? Does it feel irritating? Does it feel itchy? If that's just the case, you need to let it go because you're not going to want to wear that item. The next question to ask yourself is, how do I feel wearing this? You want to feel like $1 million. You want to know that if you bumped into your ex-boyfriend or ex-girlfriend wearing this particular item, you'd feel good about yourself. If you think, oh God, that would be my worst nightmare, bumping into them wearing this, then there's your answer. Let it go. Third question is, how is the cut? How is the size? Again, if anything's grabbing you in somewhere that you're not proud of, you know, enhancing a particular feature of your body that you would rather maybe tone down, again, let it go. The fourth question to ask yourself as you're going through is the quality. Is this item starting to look tired or worn out? I don't want to sound like someone who's super materialistic and, you know, is like, oh, looking tired, tatty, throw it away. Of course, there are things that you can get fixed. You can dye things, you can change buttons, you can get things altered and mended and adjusted. However, at the end of the day, you still don't feel good about it and you know it's still not going to work for your body and your body shape and feel good, then simply let it go. So please make sure as you do this process, you learn a lesson each time so that you're not decluttering and minimizing your life to let a whole pile of new stuff come back in and repeat history again. Use this as an opportunity to learn, evolve, and grow. All right, everyone, I better get listing these items on the Canna Campbell Instagram account. Of course, if you're interested in any of these, please check out my account. You might be able to grab a bargain. I promise you, I'm not here to make a whole pile of money. I'm letting a lot of these items go because I've made peace with all the umming and ahhing as to whether I should let them go. All right, everyone, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I promise you, I'll be back to creating more minimalism content for you. Ciao for now.